Welcome back. Thank you for joining us. And thank you for staying on this journey for this whole week when we've been studying about loving God. This week, we've been studying about how to love God and the different ways by which we can express and demonstrate our love for God. Loving God is loving people. When we trust Him, we love Him. When we worship Him, we love Him, and so on. So today, specifically, we're going to look at this topic that when we worship Him only, that is our demonstration of our love for God, when we worship Him only. We see this conversation that the Lord Jesus has with the scribe in Mark chapter 12. And in Mark chapter 12, the Lord answers the scribe's question about what is the great commandment. And He answers by saying, the first of all commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. So He's inviting the scribe to acknowledge and recognize who God is. When we acknowledge and when we come to the recognition of who God is, and that is worship. Right? And then He goes on to give the instruction of how to love, love with all our heart and all our soul and with all our mind and so on, right? So we see this when we acknowledge who God is, when we come to the recognition of who God is, that is the first step. That is, in fact, worship. Psalm 95. In Psalm 95, the psalmist actually invites everyone to come and worship God. He says, he invites people and he says, come, you know, sing to Him, shout joyfully to Him, lift your hands, and then so on. And then he acknowledges God in worship by saying, the Lord is the great God and the great King above all gods. So we see when we acknowledge and when we recognize who God is, that is worship. Psalm 27, to worship is to gaze at His beauty. To worship the Lord is to adore Him. To worship the Lord is to desire to be with Him. So we see this when we acknowledge God, when we recognize who God is, when we desire to be with Him, and when we desire to surrender ourselves, you know, that is to worship God. And when we worship God only, when He alone is our object of worship, that is our expression of our love for God. So let us ask God today to make us true worshipers who will worship in spirit and in truth, who will come before God without any pretense, without any hypocrisy, who will come before Him in love, who will draw before Him as true worshipers, not only with our lips, not only with our words, but out of our hearts, and acknowledge Him as our God and no other, that we will treat Him as the object of worship and no other. Nothing else will take the place of our God in worship. Nothing else will substitute for the worship of our God. You know, we can say we worship God, but we can actually have an idol. We can have something, maybe a person, maybe a position, maybe power, maybe money. We could have any substitute in place of God, despite us saying that we worship God. So today, let's bring all substitutes or remove all substitutes and say, the Lord alone is my object of worship, and I'm going to worship Him only. And when we do that, we love God. Let's pray. Lord, we come before You. Lord, we pray that You would make us true worshipers who will worship You in spirit, out of our innermost being, and in truth. And Lord, we pray that we would keep no other, Lord, as our object of worship, but only You, God. Let there be no substitutes, let there be no idols in our hearts. Let there be no other person, no other thing, no other created thing take that place of worship, for You are our one true God. We thank You, we worship You, and we love You. We thank You. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.